So it's been quite a while since the last time I felt like doing a fashion trends type of video because let's be real, our world is still in a really crazy place. But lately I've been feeling super inspired by everything that I have been seeing and I finally feel like I can see a light at the end of the tunnel and I'm excited to dress up and experiment and try all of these different fashion trends. And I also feel like a lot of these fashion trends are super wearable and there are things that you can do right now to lift your mood and help you feel better. So like pretty much everyone, I have been living in comfortable clothing, whether it be sweatpants or comfy denim. And recently I have been seeing this really cool kind of laid back combination of pairing comfortable clothing such as denim with something super fancy like a glitzy going out party shoe. I think that this is a really interesting juxtaposition and I'm sure many of us own a pair of shoes that we are dying to wear but are just too fancy to wear out and about right now. But if you combine it with something that is more laid back and casual such as denim or sweatpants, it makes the look a lot more wearable. Another fashion trend that I went a little crazy with this year is rope sandals. I cannot wait until it warms up enough in Toronto for me to wear this trend. I recently picked up two pairs of rope sandals from this new brand that I discovered called Nomads, I believe. I picked up a pair of shoes for myself and a matching pair for my baby girl so we can have mommy and me matching rope sandals for the summer. I think they're super cute.
Whose shoes are those?
Mama.
Mama. Whose shoes are these?
Harry.
They're also very affordable, very high quality. So if you didn't want to spend a lot of money on this trend, this is a great way to dabble in it without spending a fortune. On the other side of the spectrum, a lot of designers such as Chanel and Valentino are coming out with these chunky rope sandals that I think are so cool. And I do think it's something that you can wear year after year. It's a classic kind of gladiator sandal look, especially if you go with the more gladiator style over the orthopedic shoe style. It's something that you can wear it with so many different things, from denim, skirts, dresses, shorts, whatever it is you're in the mood for. It's super wearable, especially if you get it in a neutral color such as cream or nude. I personally picked up a pair of white Valentino rope sandals that I am obsessed with, and they are in that gladiator style that I feel like would go with so many different things in my wardrobe that I am so excited to start wearing as soon as possible. One of my favorite fashion trends that I have been loving, especially for spring and summer, is pearl jewelry. I feel like pearl jewelry has come such a long way. It's no longer your outdated kind of grandma style pearl jewelry that you would typically think of. It's a lot more cool and modern, and it's done in a very laid back and wearable way. For example, I wanted to show you a few pieces that I'm wearing today. They're by a brand called Ray, which stands for Rise Above It. And I love this brand because they were created in the midst of the pandemic. And I think it's just such a cool brand. It's super on trend, very high quality pieces. They're pieces that are super wearable. They're very affordable. And I love how they started out in the middle of all of this craziness to kind of really bring some lightness to the world. So my earrings today are also by Ray, my necklace is by Ray, and this ring is by Ray. If you want to check out any of the pieces that I'm wearing, I'll link them in my description box down below. I'm pretty sure I also have a discount code for them, so I'll make sure to leave all of that info on the screen and down in my description box. So I know that these earrings are more of a statement piece, but I feel like they are very delicate at the same time with the leaves, and they have this like really whimsical vibe about them. And I love the white pearls paired with a pop of color, such as a pop of color on the lips. I just feel like it's a very fresh and summery feel. If you want to try out the pearl trend, but want something more easy to wear, I love this necklace on a simple kind of delicate gold chain with one little pearl bauble hanging like this. You can wear it on its own, you can layer it with other pieces, and I also love that this necklace is adjustable. So you can make it shorter or longer depending on what you feel like. And I just think that it's super pretty and I'm definitely going to be wearing it all spring and summer. I've also been seeing a lot of rainbows everywhere. I feel like everyone at this point is just so tired of everything going on and we just want to brighten up our lives in any way possible. And what better way to do that than with dousing yourself in rainbow colors. I've been seeing rainbows everywhere, from shoes to sweaters to jewelry. There are so many different ways that you can integrate rainbows into your wardrobe depending on what you're comfortable with. As you can see today, I have some rainbow jewelry on. I recently purchased a pair of rainbow sandals that I'm obsessed with and cannot wait to wear. So it really depends on what you are comfortable with. You can really tailor it to your specific style and taste and make it your own. And it's definitely something that's going to elevate your mood when you wear it. Speaking of sweatsuits, I feel like we're all at the point now where we are kind of over the black, gray, navy, neutral colored sweatsuits. And I love seeing all these beautiful, vibrant, colorful sweatsuits from purple to green, pink, yellow. It really, really gets me excited and kind of takes the whole sweatsuit look and elevates it to another level. And I feel like the sweatsuits that you're seeing now, they are a lot more fresh and wearable and they don't look like you kind of just rolled out of bed and threw the first thing that you saw. They look like you put a little bit of thought into it, but at the same time, not too much thought where you look like you're trying too hard. So I've mentioned in so many of my past videos how much I love shopping vintage and pre-loved, and thankfully this is still a fashion trend that is going so strong. And if anything, I feel like season after season, there's a lot more emphasis being focused on shopping more sustainably, especially in the world's current climate. Everybody is more conscious about the things that they are purchasing. Even a lot of retailers such as H&M and Zara are starting to think about sustainability and really bring more eco-friendly pieces out to their consumers so that they are shopping smarter. And I think this is a great change. I feel like the more we vote with our dollars and support sustainable shopping, more change is going to happen. And recently I have been seeing a huge resurgence in the pre-loved market. It's actually a cool thing now if you have a vintage Gucci bag or a vintage Chanel bag. I know that in the past, pre-loved shopping had a bad rap, but nowadays you can score such beautiful pieces. I have so many beautiful pre-loved pieces in my closet. And honestly, I love the whole experience of pre-loved shopping because it's like finding that hidden gem, that little needle in the haystack. And then when you find it, it's like a high that you get. And I also love wearing things that most people don't have. Don't get me wrong, I love my Zara, but one of my biggest pet peeves is when I see like 10 other people wearing the exact same thing. I just feel like it takes the individuality out of dressing yourself and expressing yourself through fashion. So that's another reason why I try to shop pre-loved as much as possible. Another one of my favorite fashion trends that surprisingly I believe is very, very wearable are those tops that have a cutout here and a high neck. I think they are so pretty and so flattering, and it really doesn't matter what your body shape or body type is. It puts an emphasis on what I personally believe is one of the woman's most beautiful features, which is the delicate collarbone area. It highlights your shoulders in a really beautiful way. It highlights your collarbone in a really beautiful way. I also love accentuating that area by layering on necklaces. There are so many different ways that you can wear the style of top, and I just think that it's so beautiful and something I'm definitely excited to be wearing this season. Another trend that I have been loving and I think is really, really wearable are graphic t-shirts and graphic sweatshirts. I personally recently purchased this graphic sweatshirt from from Anine Bang, and I am obsessed with it. I cannot even tell you how many times I wore it. Her pieces are so high quality. I purchased one of her oversized t-shirts years ago, and I still have it to this day. And every time I wash it, it just gets better and better. It has like that lived-in vintage rock and roll vibe about it. And it's one of my favorite t-shirts in my collection because it's just so cozy and like so perfect. She really thinks through her pieces. So if you're looking for a really high quality graphic t-shirt or graphic sweatshirt, definitely check her out because she has a lot of really cool options available. But again, you can go to retailers such as Zara and get a very similar look and feel for a lot less. I just think there's something just really laid back and cool about the whole graphic t-shirt, sweatshirt trend. And I think it's something that's gonna be around for a long, long time. So as I mentioned in a lot of my previous videos, I am a tall girl. I am almost 5'10". So I personally can appreciate this next fashion trend, which is extra, extra long pants or jeans, specifically the ones that have a long slit that kind of go beyond your shoes if you are wearing a heel. Not only is it super flattering on everybody, but for a tall girl like me, I finally feel like I have found a pant that is long enough to cover my ankles, and it's awesome. And I also love the slit detail because it allows you to extend your pants beyond where the heel of your foot stops. So it elongates and stretches your legs out and makes them look miles long. Okay, so I know that we've pretty much all been living in sweatpants for the last year or so. And I know that the transition from sweatpants at home to the real world is a very, very difficult transition. But I feel like one of my favorite fashion trends is taking that really comfy, cozy vibe and combining it with real world work pieces, such as a blazer, is such a cool juxtaposition. For example, combining a oversized hoodie with a blazer, wearing leggings with a blazer. I feel like if you pair pretty much any athleisure piece or kind of like workout yoga piece with a blazer, you can probably get away with it. And I think it's so comfy and cool and just laid back. It feels like you throwed your outfit together without even thinking about it, but you look put together at the same time. And the best part is you can wear this exact same outfit to the office or to go to a workout class after work with your girls. It's a very wearable and very, very transitional. Another trend that I have been loving and that I think is super, super wearable is oversized slouchy pieces. Now, they do have to be done in the right way so you don't get into frumpy territory. So when you are wearing a slouchy oversized piece, such as an oversized hoodie or an oversized t-shirt, you want to combine it with something on the bottom that is more fitted and streamlined. So for example, a pair of black fitted leggings. Another way that you can avoid looking frumpy when you're wearing something more oversized on top is simply tucking in your shirt or your sweatshirt into your bottoms. That way it creates a little bit of shape and you have a silhouette and you're not just drowning in oversized fabric. So the exaggerated shoulders is still hot and still on trend. And I feel like if you do it in a subtle way, it's super flattering and very wearable. You can wear these pieces with so many different things, whether you decide to go with a shoulder pad or with puff sleeves. I think it adds a very unique touch, especially if you're wearing a basic such as a t-shirt or a turtleneck sweater. And it's definitely something that I see sticking around for a while. So I have already admitted that I have been living in comfy clothes over this last year, particularly t-shirts and sweatshirts. And one of the wearable trends that I really, really love and appreciate are those t-shirts and sweatshirts that have this worn-in kind of vintage look to them. I feel like it's so much more cool than wearing like a clean basic tee. It looks like it has some character. It looks like it was lived in and loved. And you can find so many worn-in kind of looking pieces affordably. and super, super high quality that will last you for many, many years to come. Another trend that I have been loving is any piece that accentuates your waist and really highlights your waist, whether it's a belt or a blazer or a coat. I really love those pieces that celebrate a woman's body and really highlight all of our best features. And one of the best ways to do that is by cinching in the waist and creating that beautiful hourglass shape. And this is super flattering on so many different body types and body shapes. And I don't know about you, but there is just something about highlighting my waist when I'm putting a look together that makes me feel a lot more confident. So another colorful trend that I've been loving and I think is so, so wearable are pastels. I think that if you're not keen on trying out something that is really bold in your face and colorful, try pastels because I feel like they are a lot softer and work well with so many different skin tones and hair colors. And it's a great way to uplift your mood and really brighten up your complexion without making you feel uncomfortable. And you can find pastels implemented into so many different pieces these days, from shirts to sweatsuits to jewelry. So you can really dabble in whatever makes you feel most comfortable. All right guys, so that wraps up today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments if there are any wearable fashion trends that you are just so excited to wear right now. I don't know about you, but I'm just so excited for all of this to be over so that we can go back to just living and enjoying our lives. And I really hope that this video gave you some inspiration and some outfit or fashion ideas to look forward to, because I am just so freaking excited just to dress up at every opportunity I have. And with that, I want to thank you guys as always for watching and hanging out with me, and I will see you in my next one.